Hi guys, welcome to another WordPress migration video. This is Jamie from System22 and WebDesignAndTechTips.com. Well, in our last video, we migrated a site using a plugin called Duplicator, which is really easy to do. And if you can do it that way, because it's really simple and straightforward. Sometimes that's not going to work. There may be a PHP conflict. There may be a problem with the version of database that you've got going on. So we're going to roll through how to actually do that the manual way, which is pretty much a fail-safe way. So we've got this site online here. As you can see, it's online. And what we're going to do is we're going to back up all the files from this site and download the database and rebuild it on our local host. Now to do this, you may have already got it, but we're going to need a plugin an app called XAMPP. And if you just Google XAMPP, XAMPP, it'll bring up this page and you can go to the apachefriends.org and download it. It's very lightweight. It won't take up much space on your computer. And there's a Windows flavor and a Linux flavor and a Mac flavor. Just download whatever version you need and install it on your computer. So once you've got it installed, we're going to want to run this, and it's going to be this little orange icon down here. Now I'm using an older version, which I probably need to update, but it's been working so well for me, I haven't done it yet. So yours may look, the interface on yours may look slightly different. So once you run it, this is what's going to come up. You want to make sure that your Apache and MySQL are started. And if they're not, just hit the start button. That'll be up here where it says stop. Okay, so we got that running. First thing we want to do, obviously, you've got to have the login credentials for the website that you want to move. Now, you don't want to go to the dashboard. That's not going to help this time. You've actually got to go to the hosting provider itself. If you're using something like GoDaddy, it'll have a cPanel, something like this. And you want to go to your file manager. If you're using a different one like iPage, they're slightly different, but they all have the same features as the file manager. And we're going to be using the file manager and the MySQL database. It's the two features we're going to use. We'll do it with this one today. So there's a file manager. And there's the MySQL. But we're probably going to be using the PHP MyAdmin. But first thing we want to do is the file manager for the site. Let's click on it. And it takes us to the file manager. Now everything is usually in the public HTML right here. Now here are all the files for the website that we want to back up. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the first one. I'm going to hold my shift key down and click on the last one. That's going to select all of those files. Now what I want to do is zip these up or compress them. So if we go up here, we've got compress. Hit that. I'm going to ask it to do a zip archive. Hit compress. And what it's done, click back on here and do a refresh or a reload. So that's created our WordPress admin zip. It's given it the name of that first file there. But it has got all of these files inside of it. And what I want to do is click on it, highlight it, and hit the download button. And as you can see, it's downloading to my desktop there. And you want to keep that safe somewhere. We're going to need it in a minute. Now I know, because I've done it before, iPage doesn't let you compress files, so you're probably going to have to do this via an FTP client, something like FileZilla here, which again is another free one. And if you just Google FileZilla, there it is right there, and you can download it. And again, it's very lightweight. They've got one for all platforms. They've got the Windows one there. And it's what they call an FTP client, which means file transport protocol, which enables you to transport files from one place to another. And basically, when you open it, when you hook up to your server, just go to your FTP, create a user. You'll connect and have your server files on the right-hand side and your local files on your computer on the left-hand side. And all you do is select them and drag them across. So that's an option if you can't compress and download like we've done with this file here. Okay, so that's step one. Next thing we're going to want to do is we'll go back to our cPanel here. We're going to want to download the database. And just to show you, as our file manager, if you're not sure what the database is called, let's go down to our WordPress wp-config file right here. You see wp-config. I'm going to edit it. And there's a warning, obviously. We're not actually going to make any changes right now. But if you look down there, here's the user. Here's the database password. And at the top is the database name. So it's System22 Fashion, if you're not sure what the database name was. So I'm going to just close that out. That's how to find the name of your database if you're not sure what it was. And quite often you might be dealing with a client that has multiple sites on there. So there's going to be multiple databases. So we're back to the cPanel now. Let's go down to phpMyAdmin. And once in there, it gives you a list of a few of the databases that are here. And the name of the one that we wanted was that fashion right there. So I'm just clicking on it. What it's done, it's brought up that database. And what we need to do is come up here and hit the export button. Quick, display only the minimal options. That's absolutely fine. We want it to be SQL. There are other options there, but use SQL for this. And when you're ready, hit the Go button. And again, it's done the download for us here. And I obviously hit that button again, it's downloaded it again. So we want to browse to where these files are and keep them safe. So I'm going to browse to those. And I've put them in a little folder because we're going to want to use those in a moment. Okay, so that's the backup, online backup taken care of there. That's all we need to do there. So like I said earlier, once you've got XAMPP installed, downloaded and installed on your computer, if you go to your main computer C drive, usually, or whatever the drive letter is, that's your main drive with all your programs and everything on it. If you go down, you're going to see XAMPP, a folder called XAMPP installed there. I'm going to double click on there. And inside, locate the folder called htdocs. That, inside that, is where we put all of our websites that we've built locally. As you can see, I've got a whole bunch here. You're probably only going to have a few folders there with things like restricted and PHP and stuff like that on there. So let's create a new folder for the website that we want to download. I'm just going to call it F1 because I've actually already got that site out here as fashion when we did it the other way yesterday. Okay, so it's in the folder called F1. I'm going to open that folder. Now I'm going to copy over the zip file that we downloaded from our live site. Okay, I'm actually going to rename this because when it unzips, I've got a folder inside there called WordPress Admin, and it's going to put this in a folder called WordPress Admin, and that might cause problems. So I'm just going to right-click, hit Rename, and call it Admin2. Really doesn't matter what you put on the end as long as it's changed it from that initial. So I'm going to right-click, hit Extract here. And there we are, it's extracted it all here. And what I'm gonna do is I can delete that zip file. We no longer need that. So I'm gonna hit Shift Delete. And get rid of that file. So basically we've got all of our website files right here. Now then, our next step, we'll keep this folder open, is we wanna go to our XAMPP software that we've installed here. And to do that, we want to go to localhost. Just type in localhost, L-O-C-A-L-H-O-S-T. And that'll bring us up to this window. Like I said earlier, I've got an earlier version of this and it works fine. You may have a newer version with your menu up the top. But what we're going to be using is the PHP MyAdmin, and yours will have that somewhere, so just look for it. And let's click on that. And what I'm going to do, you can create a new database if you want to, then you'll have to create a user, but I'm going to go ahead to users, click on users, scroll down, and I'm going to say add user. And I'm going to make this really easy. You want to use stronger passwords that I'm going to use here. I'm just going to call it F1. It's going to be the local host. I'm going to use the password of F1, which is really weak. Like I say, you want to have a nice strong password for yours. But I'm going to delete this site off both the live and the local later on, so it doesn't matter. If you want to generate a strong password, just click on that button there. So we've got a username of F1, and we've got a password of F1 and F1 there also. I want to scroll down a little bit, and I'm going to check the little box that says create database with the same name and grant all privileges. And that's going to give it all the privileges to be able to write to the files. Once we're happy with that, we're going to go down to the right hand side and click the go button. Right, we've added a new user. Don't need to save that. Again, like we said yesterday, this LastPass is what I use for managing my passwords. I've got hundreds and hundreds of them, and if your memory is a bit shoddy like mine, it's a great little free app, LastPass, that is. Okay, so we've done pretty much what we wanted to do there. We've created the database, and we've created a user. Now, you know, I said keep that folder open just now. What we've got to do is go into our WordPress config file again. And I'm going to open it with a piece of software called Brackets, which is a great free text editor. If you don't have it, you can get it from brackets.io. I'll just do a Google search for Brackets. There it is right there, brackets.io. Just click on it and you can download it. It's absolutely free and it's a wonderful text editor. So I've opened that with my bracket software. And just to demonstrate once again, I'm sorry to keep flashing screens up at you. Once you've got brackets installed, it'll show these icons for these files here. And as long as you've checked the option, there'll always be an open with brackets appendage here when you right click on a file. So that's all I've done to open it in the brackets there. All right. So if we open this, we can see all the junk that's in there. Most of it's of not much interest, but if we go down to database name, we've got to change that to the new one that we just created. So it was F1. Database user was also F1. Database password, you guessed it, it was F1. And like I say, do use a strong password for yours. Don't use a silly one like mine. Database host is localhost, which that can stay the same. Character set and collate, you don't need to change at all. And all you need to do is go up and hit save or hit Control S on your keyboard. Now we've actually told it now the database that we want it to use here. So now we created that database, Let's go back to our local host. We'll click on that database, F1. What we want to do is import the file that we downloaded. So we want to roll over to import. Again, you may have a newer version of this, but it will have an import button there. And we'll hit choose file. And you just need to browse to the folder that's got that database file that we downloaded earlier from the online site. There it is right there. As you can see, it's put it there. So when we're happy, just hit the go button. And that's it. It says the import has been successfully finished. So we actually need to go in here to our F1 file. We want to go to our options folder. Okay, once we've got that open, we want to go over here. And if we look at the first two lines, that's where the old site was. The online site, we need to change that to our local site URL. So let's hit the edit. We want to direct it to the local host. So I'm going to say http://. And where does it live? It's localhost, and it's /, the name of the folder, which was F1. Here's that folder, and it was called F1. And we're dealing with localhost, so it's http://F1. So I'm going to copy that. I'm going to hit go to update it. There it is right there. And we'll do it to the next one below as well with the home. And I'll just paste in what I just copied. Hit the go. That's it. That should be our last step. Now let's see if it's actually worked. So let's open a new tab. And we want to go to localhost, localhost, /, name of the folder, which is F1. Hit return and let's see what's going to happen. There it is. There's our site. Now it's locally on our machine. And it should be a perfect clone of our online site here. Here's our online site. If I go across, here's our local site. Let's make sure it's going to work. There we go. Works absolutely fine. So that is how to manually transfer a WordPress site from an online host to your local host. I hope that's been useful to you. Thanks for watching.